Thoroughbred Action is presented by Hardacre Farm.
Welcome to Thoroughbred Action from Gulfstream Park. Happy Friday. It's Beat the Expert Day as well, and we have 11 races on today's card. Let's get right to the track and weather conditions.
We start the afternoon with the fast main track and a firm turf course. Temperatures in the upper 70s here today with partly cloudy skies. First race of the afternoon over the main track at 6 furlongs. Claimers which have not won 3 in for a price tag of $6,250. A field of 8. The first race favorite, number 5, Summer Whites.
Racing at Gulfstream. Summer Whites begins nicely. There goes Palmera on the drop in class, and from the rail, Playa Zaragoza away in the top flight. Charming Fantasy is now 4th. Taylor Priscelli down to the inside 5th, followed outside by Miss Steffi, then Miss Regalite, and 2 to the trailer. Sensational Saturday. Down the backstretch they go, and as they race to the half-mile pole, up front, Playa Zaragoza and Palmera duke it out through the opening quarter. Down at the inside, Taylor Priscelli takes 3rd. Summer Whites is now 4th. From 5th in Charming Fantasy, then to the outside, Miss Steffi. At the inside, Miss Regalite and Sensational Saturday is last as the opening quarter went in 23-1. To the top of the stretch they go. Playa Zaragoza on the inside, Palmera on the outside, their heads apart. The second flight horse is just waiting in the wings. Summer Whites is now 3rd, given the green light. Taylor Priscelli looks to have horse, no place to prove it. Stretch of another 4 lengths back to the outside, and Miss Steffi as they turn in. Palmera is set down for the drive and tries to edge away. From the outside, Summer Whites is still keeping Taylor Priscelli boxed in. Playa Zaragoza is at the inside in deep stretch. Summer White's trying to get to Palmera. Palmera digs deep on the outside, and Summer White surging late. Summer White's has got her. Summer White's in front. Palmera 2nd, Taylor Priscelli 3rd, Playa Zaragoza 4th, Sensational Saturday 5th in 1:13-1.
Number 5, Summer White's gets the job done here today under jockey Paco Lopez for trainer Murat Sankal and owner Alp Eventsman. 2nd with 6, Palmera ahead of the 3, Taylor Priscelli, who ran 3rd. To the second race we go now, race number 2 at 7 furlongs, the start of the early pick 4. Claimers which have not won 3 are in for a price tag of $30,000. Tyler Gaffleone on number 3, Gone Local, a field of 7. Betting favorites included 5, Mock My Day, and 7, Moonlight Bandit.
And they're off. From the outside, that's Moonlight Bandit who gets the first call. Sent hard is Mock My Day. Padilla from down toward the inside, and He's Cotton comes away in the top flight. These 4 are quickest. They quickly work 2 lengths better than Gone Local, followed by the comebacker Midnight Cello, and the trailer is the Great Casby. Down the backstretch they go, and up front, Padilla puts ahead in front. Right there with him 2nd is Mock My Day. He's Cotton and Moonlight Bandit, they comprise the top 4. And they've opened 3 now on Midnight Cello, who's trying to tack on 5th. Gone Local is back 2nd last, and the Crate Casby is last with half a mile to go. Up front, Padilla has now worked clear of Mock My Day, leads it a half a length. Moonlight Bandit is waiting in the wings, 3rd in range. He's Cotton drops over to the inside to save some ground around the 4-turn run. 2 better than Midnight Cello, who starts to work closer. Then down at the inside goes Gone Local, and the Great Casby tries to play catch up at the back through a 45-3 opening half mile. They run to the top of the stretch. Padilla has the lead. Mock My Day right with him 2nd. He's Cotton will tip off their flank to try to challenge the top flight with a quarter of a mile left to go. Padilla on the inside. On the outside, it's Mock My Day. Mock My Day puts ahead in front. He's Cotton is 3rd and not done trying. Midnight Cello at the inside 4th. Final furlong. Mock My Day strides to a short lead. Midnight Cello is back to 4th, back 2nd is Padilla, but the winner is Mock My Day. Moving away by 2, 2nd Padilla, 3rd he's Cotton, 4th Midnight Cello, and 5th was Moonlight Bandit in 1:24 flat.
Number 5, Mock My Day grinds out a victory in today's second race under jockey Javier Castellano for trainer Alan Iwinski and Boca Friends. 2nd 2, Padilla, 3rd 6, he's Cotton. We'll take a brief time out. When we come back, we have more great racing action on the Friday card right after this.
We have to take care of these horses that, you know, give us so much joy.
Being accredited by the TAA gives us instant credibility.
People trust us even more than they have before because they know that the TAA has been to all of our locations and that our horses are well cared for.
I mean, this farm wouldn't look the way it is, these horses wouldn't look the way they are if it wasn't for the generosity and the hard work of the Thoroughbred Aftercare Alliance.
They've united our whole industry in terms of the aftercare movement.
We're all working together for the same purpose.
Back for the third race at 7 furlongs over the main track, Maiden Claimer's in for a price tag of $12,500. A late scratch of number 6, My Little Princess, left us with a field of 7. The heavy favorites were 5, I'm Thirsty, and 8, Poopsie Doopsie.
And they're off. From the outside, Poopsie Doopsie begins nicely from the rail. Here's speed from Tricky Moon, but Poopsie Doopsie will cross in front and lead the way out of the chute. I'm Thirsty now moves to be second. Down at the inside, that's Tricky Moon third. From fourth, Wild Dalton, then Pachamanca. In between horses goes Year Ruby, and Misty Spirit is the trailer as they run down the backstretch. Poopsie Doopsie and Miguel Vasquez were intent on the lead, and they lead it now by a length. I'm Thirsty second through a 23-1 opening quarter. They've opened 3 on Wild Dalton, who's racing from third. Down at the inside, that's Tricky Moon on fourth. Moving between horses, Yerubi, out wide Pachamanca, and 3 to the trailer, Misty Spirit. They move around the far turn and approach the 3-furlong point. Off the fence, here comes Paco Lopez on I'm Thirsty, which means he's getting serious, trying to get to the leader, Poopsie Doopsie. Wild Dalton in with an upset possibility, 12-1 and tacking on through a 46 4/2 mile. These top three have isolated themselves from the rest of the field, led by Pachamanca and Misty Spirit with 1/4 mile to go. I'm Thirsty just took the lead while confidently handled. Wild Dalton moves to around the outside second. Poopsie Doopsie is now back to third and on retreat. 3:16 to go. Out in the center, here's the run from Wild Dalton, sweeping up to challenge I'm Thirsty for the lead. 5 lengths back to Misty Spirit and Poopsie Doopsie. Wild Dalton has the momentum. I'm Thirsty back to second. Wild Dalton will spring the upset and win it by a length in the end. I'm Thirsty second ahead of Misty Spirit third, then Poopsie Doopsie and Pachamanca in 1:26 4.
Number 5, I'm Thirsty, was aroused a little bit too late. By then, number 3, Wild Dalton, already had a full head of steam, and Wild Dalton springs the 12-1 upset under jockey Luca Panici for our Sugar Bear stable and trainer Fernando Abreu. 5, I'm Thirsty second, ahead of number 2, Misty Spirit, who ran third. To the fourth race, we go at a mile over the turf. Claimers in for a price tag of $16,000. They've not won 3. Scratch the 9, Bellamy Torch, a field of 8. The betting favorite, number 2, Breakaway.
And they're off. From the outside, Moise begins nicely. So does It's High Time from down toward the inside. Breakaway and Alley Cruz both begin well. They're 3rd and 4th. From 5th, that's Queen of Silence, followed by Troya. Second last, Silver Sassy, and dropping the trail, the stretch runner, Voila La Victoire, as they round the first turn. Up front, the leader is It's High Time, and Raul Mena to lead it by 3 over Moise second. Alley Cruz is 3rd, Breakaway races from 4th. On hold 5th is Troya, then Queen of Silence. Down at the inside goes Silver Sassy, and trailing is Voila La Victoire. The opening quarter was 23-1, and up the backstretch they go at 30-1. It's High Time has the lead here by 3.5 lengths. Moise is 2nd. Alley Cruz is 3rd. On the outside, Breakaway, Luis Saez moved her to the outside to make a move. Queen of Silence now moves into her spot. She's 4th down toward the inside. Troya is next, then Voila La Victoire and Silver Sassy. 47-2 for the opening half mile. Around the far turn they go. Up top, the leader still It's High Time by a length. Moise second. 4 wide Breakaway, 3 wide Alley Cruz. At the inside, it's Queen of Silence, followed by Voila La Victoire, 2 better than Troya, then Silver Sassy. They run to the top of the stretch now. Moise in the pink colors goes to put ahead in front. Breakaway moves to her, and Voila La Victoire moves to both of them. After 3 quarters in 1:11 4, they turn in. Here's Voila La Victoire trying to get to Breakaway up front. Breakaway puts ahead in front. Voila La Victoire set down, driving in, gaining ground second. Back third is Moise. Inside the final furlong, Voila La Victoire ahead in front. Breakaway still right there. Voila La Victoire. And Edgar Prado win it. Second, Breakaway close after that in 1:35 4.
Number 2, Breakaway moved to the outside around the far turn, but was wide for too long, and that allowed number 7, Voila La Victoire, to kick by for the win under jockey Edgar Prado for trainer Tom Albertroni and TA Racing. 2, Breakaway was game while second ahead of Longshot 6, Troya, who ran third. To race number 5 now, 7 furlongs over the main track, an allowance optional claiming event for a purse of $48,000. Rider change on 7, Money or Love, to Luis Castillo. Betting favorite, number 4, Pauly's Express.
And they're off. From the outside, Curlin's Image wins the start and tries to establish a clear lead. Moving to be second is A Little Attitude. Racing third is Polly's Express. Crowning Affair, down to her inside, is now fourth. Up on the outside, Money or Love is fifth. Racing second last is Last Kiss. And Conquest Superstep is last of all at about 6 lengths off the lead. Down the backstretch they go, and up top, the leader is Curlin's Image, and Nick Juarez trying to back down the speed. Having none of that is A Little Attitude, who races on her flank second. Crowning Affair moved through a nice hole for Gaffleone to take third, ahead of her stablemate Polly's Express, who's now fourth. Back fifth is Last Kiss, then to the inside Conquest Superstep, and Money or Love is the trailer. Around the far turn they go. They went 22 and 4 for the opening quarter speed. Curlin's Image held together up front by a neck. Here's Polly's Express. 3 wide and on the attack. Money or Love is 4 wide in the 2-path. Long shot, A Little Attitude. Waiting in the wings. Crowning Affair needs a way through. Patiently handled with Last Kiss second last. And the trailer is Conquest Superstep as they run to the top of the stretch. Up for a short lead is A Little Attitude. In front now by a length. Polly's Express second. Crowning Affair has to peel all the way to the outside third for a stretch bid. Inside the final furlong, here's Polly's Express now driving to the lead. Trying to get into second is Crowning Affair ahead of A Little Attitude, who still gained for second, but they come to the wire. Polly's Express will win it. Polly's Express by 4 in the end. Give A Little Attitude second ahead of Crowning Affair third, then Conquest Superstep in 123-1. Number 4, Polly's Express, comes ready to roll off the layoff in race number 5 and wins easily under jockey John Velasquez for trainer Ralph Nix and owners PHS Racing. Number 5, A Little Attitude, fought on well at a big price to get second, ahead of the one, Crowning Affair, who shook loose to get third. Early pick 4, $373.10. The early pick 5, $826 for a 50-cent wager. We'll take a brief timeout. When we come back, we'll bring you the Rainbow Six sequence right after this.
Passion for horses and a commitment to breed champions is the foundation of Hardacre Farm. Founded in 1999 by Amy Tarrant, owner, breeder, and trainer, Hardacre Farm, now based in Ocala, continues its tradition of success. From the Breeders' Cup to Gulfstream Park, Hardacre Farm. From the breeding shed to the racetrack, in pursuit of producing the best.
Saturday, March 4th, the road to the Triple Crown continues at Gulfstream Park. Don't miss the country's top 3-year-olds compete in the Grade 2 ExpressBet.com Fountain of Youth Stakes as they continue their journey to Derby glory. 9 total stakes races, $1.5 million on the line, a thrilling day of live racing. The Grade 2 Fountain of Youth Stakes. Derby contenders start here. Welcome to your playground, Gulfstream Park.
Back for race number 6 at 7.5 furlongs over the turf. Claimer's in for a price tag of $16,000. Scratch the 3, Mr. Magic. Scratch the 10, Bocotti. A field of 8, all the money on 2, Leonardo da Vinci. And 9, Xandar.
And they're off. From the outside, Golden Pirate wins the break, and he'll drop over to the inside and lead the way on the run to the first turn from Point Roll, who comes away racing second. Xandar's on the outside, Leonardo da Vinci is at the rail, and Sea Cookie is between horses. They're followed at the back of the pack by a team comprised by Wickstead and Gisnell, and Bridge of Luck trails as they round the first turn. Golden Pirate has the lead a half a length. On the outside and tugging from second is Point Roll. Down at the inside, Leonardo da Vinci is also tugging. Sea Cookie's in tight. He's tugging. Out wide on the course and trying to improve a bit is Wickstead. It's a stretch of another 2 lengths back to the inside. That's Gisnell, and Bridge of Luck is last. Down the backstretch they go, and up front, Golden Pirate slowing down the pace through the opening quarter in 24 flat. Right on the outside of him is Point Roll from second. Xandar third, while 3 wide. At the inside, it's Leonardo da Vinci fourth. Then comes Sea Cookie fifth, followed by Wickstead, then Gisnell, and Bridge of Luck. They move into the far turn, and up front, the leader, Golden Pirate, led out a notch by Rosario and leads it a half a length. 3 wide, Xandar in the 2-path Point Roll. Leonardo da Vinci is fourth. He's dropped 2 lengths off the lead, followed by Sea Cookie and Wickstead. Then at the inside goes Gisnell, and Bridge of Luck will have to pass them all with 1/4 mile left to go. Xandar up to challenge Golden Pirate, who cuts the corner and still maintains the lead. It's Golden Pirate into the stretch with the lead. Xandar to the throat latch and now to the front. On the outside, and Leonardo da Vinci is coming on. Bridge of Luck from last up the inside. Final furlong, Xandar, Leonardo da Vinci. Leonardo da Vinci launching late. Leonardo da Vinci in time. Xandar second, close for third. Either Golden Pirate or Bridge of Luck in 129-3. Favorites run 1-2 in today's sixth race. It's 2, Leonardo da Vinci, who's up to win it under jockey Javier Castellano for trainer Safi Joseph Jr. and drawing away stable. Good run from 9, Xandar, to complete a formful exacta. 5, Bridge of Luck, got running to be third. To the seventh race we go now. Seventh race at 6 furlongs. Claimers in for a price tag of $35,000. These are three-year-olds. Field of 8 went postward. The favorites were 5, Vencedor, and 8, Kraken John.
And they're off. From the outside, Kraken John blasts out to take a clear early lead. Moving between horses to take second is Dawn Raider. Ledbetter is showing speed up the inside. Love conquers as they converge on Kraken John, who has the lead. At 5 wide, while sent along by Jose Ortiz, is Vencedor. Chatham at his 6 wide. Then Charlie the Greek, who saves ground down toward the inside. And 2 to the trailer. The trailer is our Sarge. Past the half-mile pole, things crowded up front. Standing room only. Speaking of standing room, tapping on the brakes there was Vencedor. He's now back 5th. With the lead, Love Conquers by a head. Ledbetter is 2nd. 3 wide and 3rd is Dawn Raider. Chatham in his 4th while 4 wide. Charlie the Greek rides the rail into contention. He saved ground throughout. Vencedor trying to re-rally. He's all been very wide throughout. Kraken John is 2nd last, and trailing the field is R. Sarge with a quarter of a mile to go. 46 and 2 for the opening half mile. And Chatham now comes to take the lead. On the far outside, a late run from Vencedor. Charlie the Greek looks for racing room. Kraken John on the far outside. But Chatamant getting away. Chatamant leads it by 2.5. Here's Charlie the Greek surfacing late to get into 2nd. R. Sarge lost the rider. Coming to the line, it will be Chatamant to win it. 2nd, Charlie the Greek. 3rd, Kraken John. 4th, Vencedor in 1:12 flat.
A lot of the contenders in race 7 were wide on the course, and such was the case with the 7, Chatamant, who wins anyway under jockey Manny Aguilar for trainer Cecil Paul and owner David Fernandez. 5, Charlie the Greek saved ground, had to shake loose though to get 2nd ahead of the 8, Kraken John, who dropped back and came again, got 3rd. 5, Vencedor completes the super. To the 8th race now at 5 furlongs over the turf, an allowance optional claiming event. Horses in for a price tag of $25,000. Luis Castillo on 5, Congressional Storm, a field of 8. The favorite was number 6, Glass House.
And they're off. For the inside, Maria begins nicely. So does Scuba Sue, who's heading off for the year lead. Hila moves a 3-3 wide on the outside. Congressional Storm now racing from 4th. Outside in 5th, it's Crazy About Jazz. Then comes Indominus. Glass House is 2nd last, and the early trailer swimming. They make their way to the far turn. Maria has inside position and a narrow lead. Scuba Sue right back at her 2nd. From 3rd, it's Hila from 4th and trying to run on. It's Crazy About Jazz. Then comes Congressional Storm, followed by Indominus. Out of last is Swimming. And Glass House, one of the favorites here, not strutting out all that well and not asked for much either, last of all, and at this point looks beaten as they turn for home. Scuba Sue up for a short lead. Maria right back at her 2nd over the top. Hila's now 3rd from 4th. Crazy About Jazz winding up from 5th is Indominus. Final furlong, nothing decided yet. Scuba Sue has a short lead. Hila will take a push on the outside. Scuba Sue and Hila. Scuba Sue will win it. Hila's 2nd. 3rd, Maria. Close after that, maybe Swimming for 4th in 55-2.
Number 6, Glass House, just never took part in this race, was far back until the top of the stretch, and that allowed the Speedball 3, Scuba Sue, to get up for the score under jockey Amisael Jaramillo for trainer Jorge Navarro and Monster Racing. 7, Hila tried her late, but had to settle for 2nd ahead of the 1, Maria, who set the pace and ended up 3rd. To the 9th race now, the first leg of the lead pick 3 on turf at 7.5 furlongs. A field of 11 went postward with the scratch of number 12, Theophilia. The favorites included number 11, Frosty Friday, and number 9, the comebacker, Justice Animal.
And they're off. From the center, More Than a Party gets the first call. Moving up on the outside, here's Mississippi Delta to show speed. In between horses, Justice Animo a bit keen while racing in 3rd. From the outside, that's Frosty Friday taking over 4th down at the inside out. Southern Gem is in the 2 path and races about 4 lengths off the lead. Trying to move over from the outside, that's Bibby. Bibby's situated about 5 lengths behind. She works a length in front of the stretch out running Moon River, who's 2 clear of Peru, 2.5 lengths to A Lot of Skirt, and an EB rider is last of the 11 as they roll into the backstretch. More Than a Party on the board at 60-1 and into the backstretch with a length to lead. Mississippi Delta 2nd, Justice Animo well spotted 3rd. Frosty Friday is now 4th, inside out is 5th, followed by Southern Gem 6th. Bibby is 7th, Moon River is 8th, Peru is 9th, 10th on the inside, A Lot of Skirt, and trailing is EB Rider. They make their way past the half-mile mark. They went through the opening half-mile after the opening quarter in 23-2. The half-mile was complete in 47-2. Around the fourth turn they go. More Than a Party has it by a length. On the outside in Mississippi, Delta second, Frosty Friday third. From fourth and inside, Joss DeSanimo. Then Southern Gem, trying to look for room, is inside out, drawing within four lengths of the lead while needing some place to work. Moon River rides the rail next as they turn for home. Up to take the lead, Mississippi Delta into the drive on a two-length lead. Joss DeSanimo second, inside out, surfaces off cover to try to run down the leader. Inside the final furlong, Mississippi Delta and Jose Lescano strong up front. They lead by two. Late push from inside out, Mississippi Delta wins. Inside out second, Joss DeSanimo third. Close for fourth, Southern Gem or Peru in 129 flat.
Nice performance on a course that she has shown affinity for in the past by number 10, Mississippi Delta, who gets the score under jockey Jose Lescano for trainer Mark Cassie and owners Mike Rutherford and Jackpot Ranch. Number one, Inside Out, closed good ground to get second ahead of the nine, Joss DeSanimo. She'll be better next time. She ran third. We'll take a brief timeout. When we come back, we'll bring you the late daily double on the Friday card up next.
Crossing the finish line for the last time can mean an uncertain future for many horses. Recognizing the need for a dignified retirement, the racing industry has made racehorse aftercare a top priority. In partnership with Gulfstream Park and the Florida Horsemen's Association, Florida Track provides retraining and adoption services for retired racehorses. Thanks to their efforts, the end of a racing career can signal the beginning of a new career. In show jumping, trail riding, police work, even therapy for children and veterans. However, good intentions do not come without cost. As a nonprofit organization, Florida Track relies on tax-deductible donations and volunteers to help pay for feed, training, housing, and veterinary care. To find out how you can help, contact Florida Track today. Your support will go a long way towards a new beginning.
Back for the 10th race at 1 mile over the main track, an allowance optional claiming event. A field of eight went postward, no changes here. The favorites were the stakes winning two, Tail for Ruby, and seven, Meadow Rose.
And they're off. From the center, Linda Mimi hustled hard by Jose Ortiz to try to get the early lead. Lucky Switch has speed. Moving up on the outside is Meadow Rose and High Holiday. Tail for Ruby comes away in the top flight, but she'll be just off the leader, Linda Mimi. So it's Linda Mimi who exits the chute with the lead. Prado offensive-minded here with Tail for Ruby. She's down at the inside in a joint second. On her outside is Meadow Rose, then High Holiday. Sean has been taken to the far outside by jockey John Velasquez, followed by Lucky Switch, and at the inside, Tormenta de Oro. The trailer is Top Decile. They race down the backstretch after the opening quarter in 23-4. And up front, Linda Mimi by a half a length. Meadow Rose is second. Sean is now three wide third. Tail for Ruby is fourth. High Holiday is fifth, followed by Tormenta de Oro in sixth. Racing from seventh is Lucky Switch. And Top Decile is eighth and last and about nine lengths off the lead as they round the far turn. Up front, the leader now is Meadow Rose by a neck, moving to her. Sean now takes over second, and she's only ahead behind. Tail for Ruby, given the green light by Prado, three wide and on the attack. These three work three better than Linda Mimi, then Lucky Switch and Tormenta de Oro with a quarter of a mile left to go. Sean has the lead, turning for home. Tail for Ruby, set down for the drive and tries to get to her second. Meadow Rose is back third. Back fourth is Linda Mimi as they straighten for home. Tail for Ruby, fully stretched but up for a short lead. Meadow Rose is game. Sean is next. Linda Mimi, also extra game. She's trying to battle back. Linda Mimi is battling back, but Tail for Ruby has the lead, and it will be Tail for Ruby to win it by a length in the end. Linda Mimi, some kind of game to get second ahead of Sean third. Meadow Rose ran fourth in 137-1.
Hall of Famer Edgar Prado gets his second winner of the afternoon aboard number two, Tail for Ruby, who was up to the challenge, rallied in the center of the course to get the score for trainer Barkley Tagg and owners Charles Fipke. great run from number 5, Linda Beamy, to be second at a nice price ahead of the 3, Sean, who finished third. To the 11th race, we go on turf at 1 mile. Claimers, which have not won 2, and for a price tag of $30,000. Scratch the 10, Hollywood Tomcat, John Cruz on the 11, Card Spun, a field of 11. The favorites included 4, Caster, and 12, Lily's Answer.
And runners away. Good start outside for Card Spun. Down at the rail, that's Kirby's Penny showing speed. Kenitra's away in the top flight and moving between horses. Admiral's Win in the run of the first turn. It will be long shot Admiral's Win to put ahead in front of Kirby's Penny. Racing back third is Harlan's Darlin'. Out a bit wide was Card Spun. Saving ground was Caster. Kenitra between horses. They're followed by the trio of Scat's Empire, Kate Mist, and Lily's Answer. Magician's Vanity is on hold second last for Trevor McCarthy, and Any Given Trace is last of all as they roll into the backstretch, separated by 6 lengths. Up front now, it's Admiral's Win just ahead in front. Kirby's Penny second, Card Spun third. Harlan's Darlin' fourth, followed by Kenetra and Lily's Answer. Then Caster, Dorothy inside. Kate Mist is next. Magician's Vanity tries to move from the back. Out wide is moving up as Any Given Trace, and Scat's Empire is the trailer. Chess match continues after a 47 4/2 mile. Admiral's Win has the lead by a head. Card Spun still there for second. Lily's Answer a 3 wide move from her. She's now third. Also running on and from the far outside is Any Given Trace. Magician's Vanity tries to continue an assault. She's 3 wide. Backing up is Kirby's Penny. Caster has been relegated to the trailing position and trying to re-rally now as they run to the top of the stretch. Jose Ortiz, the first to face us aboard Lily's Answer, who's on a 2-length lead. Magician's Vanity comes out of the pack to try to get to her second. Card Spun is next, then Kenitra and Kate Mist. Eighth of a mile to go with the lead. Lily's Answer ducking to the inside and charging hard as Magician's Vanity. Back third is Kate Mist. In deep stretch, Lily's Answer has the lead. Second, Magician's Vanity. Lily's Answer wins. Magician's Vanity second, Kate Mist third. Close for fourth, Kenitra or Caster to complete the high five in 136 flat.
Good trip from the outside gate for number 12, Lily's Answer, who rallies for the score under jockey Jose Ortiz for trainer Mike Maker and 3 Diamonds Farm. Good run from Magician's Vanity to shake loose to get second ahead of the 6, Kate Mist, who ran third. Late pick 5, $1,344.45. In the Rainbow 6, we had multiple winning wagers to the tune of $1,383.46. Triggers a carryover of $12,901.85.
That wraps up today. We'll see you back here tomorrow. First post is 12 noon for 13 races on tap, highlighted by the Grade 3 Gulfstream Park Sprint. We'll see you then.
Hit the hay. Hit the hay. I've been working all day. Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
What do you say? Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
Well, I'm tired. Let me tell you, Jack. I'm so tired.